This is the Gadwall, and most of you have probably never heard of it, but it's an incredibly interesting species. The Gadwall, or Merica strepera, is commonly overlooked as just another duck. But it's not the same as the common duck, the mallard. Male Gadwalls are intricately patterned in gray, brown, and black, with the white wing patch and the black rump being their defining characteristics. But did you know that in early summer, for 1 to 3 weeks, ducks can't fly at all? Between May and July, waterfowl undergo what is known as a simultaneous molt, where they molt all their flight feathers at once. During this period, they are grounded and cannot fly. In ducks, such as the gadwall, the male, also known as the drake, molts into his eclipse plumage, which looks similar to the female, with brown feathers. During this time, males and females are easily confused with similar species, like the mallard. Though gadwalls are a bit smaller, with more square-shaped heads, thinner bills, and that characteristic white wing patch. Come September, drakes will undergo a partial molt, where they return to the intricately patterned plumage of grays, browns, and blacks. If you have heard of the gadwall before, you're likely either into birding or a duck hunter, as gadwalls are the third most hunted duck species after mallards and green-winged teals, with roughly 1.25 million harvested in 2020 alone. Still, gadwall populations continue to increase by almost 2% each year, with the current population estimated at roughly 4.4 million. Yes, that means almost a quarter of the population is hunted each year, and they're still increasing, thanks to tight regulations set by biologists. Gadwalls have a large range and inhabit wetlands throughout North America, Europe, Asia, and Northern Africa, as seen on this map. The gadwall belongs to the superorder Galloanserae, which was the second major clade to split off after the Paleognathae, the ratites, split from the Neognathae, which then split into the Galloanserae, the waterfowl and landfowl, and the Neowaves, which are the rest of the birds. This split actually occurred way back in the Cretaceous period. Within Galloanserae, the gadwall belongs to the order Anseriformes, along with the screamers, magpie goose, and the other waterfowl, the ducks, geese, and swans. Within the Anseriformes, the gadwall falls into the family Anatidae, along with the other ducks, geese, and swans, which appears to be sister to Anseranatidae, the magpie goose. Within the Anatidae, the gadwall is placed in the subfamily Anatinae and the tribe Anatini, the dabbling ducks, though the rest of Anatidae phylogeny is a mess, so let's just focus on this for now. Within which, it belongs to the genus Merica, which contains 5 extant species that prior to 2009 were included in the genus Anis. Though when Anis was found not to be monophyletic, it was split into 5 genera, one of which being Merica, which contains the gadwall, the falcated duck, and the 3 widgeon species, as well as the extinct Amsterdam duck. Via DNA analysis, it's been determined that the closest living relative of the gadwall is the falcated duck, Merica falcata, of Eastern Asia. At one point, there were 2 subspecies of gadwall, the common gadwall, Merica streptera streptera, and Coues' gadwall, Merica streptera coosi, which was endemic to Terina, Washington Island in the South Pacific. Only 2 specimens of this subspecies exist, which were collected in 1874, when there was apparently a decent population observed. But by 1900, no gadwall remained on this island, likely hunted to extinction by settlers from nearby islands. Gadwalls primarily feed through dabbling, that is, dipping their heads under water while their butts stick into the air. Their main diet includes aquatic vegetation and aquatic invertebrates, but they will also graze on shorelines. Kleptoparasitism, that is, stealing food from other species such as coots and other ducks, has also been observed. Gadwalls are monogamous and find mates and form pairs during autumn migration, as well as on the wintering grounds, with males having a variety of courtship displays, where they raise their heads, similar to that of the common goldeneye. I'll be doing a video on that species this winter, so make sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss it. Gadwalls nest in fields and marshes, in a dip in the ground that they line with vegetation and down, with the female laying 7 to 12 eggs in a clutch. And most males desert their mate after the clutch is laid, leaving the female to raise the chicks until she departs 10 weeks after they hatch. In addition, lesser scops, redheads, mallards, and even pheasants parasitize their nests via brood parasitism, laying eggs in their nests for them to raise. Currently, threats such as habitat loss and overharvesting are tightly managed due to the economic and subsistence value of this species, as biologists set regulations to make sure their population continues to rise. But back in the 1960s, gadwall populations were at a low of roughly 500,000 individuals, as DDT caused declines. To learn more about the environmental impact of DDT and how it almost caused the extinction of the bald eagle, you can watch our video on that here. Some main predators of gadwalls include gulls, harriers, falcons, foxes, minks, weasels, coyotes, badgers, and humans, while raccoons and skunks also prey on their eggs. Gadwalls are an incredibly interesting duck species, and now you can recognize them next time you're at a wetland or a local park. Make sure to subscribe, like, share, and comment on which species we should do next on animal analysis. And maybe check out one of these other videos